Third time lucky, Judith Collins said last night with a smile as the MP for Papakura became the leader of the National Party. It's no secret that this is a job she's wanted. Politics is full of people pretending they don't want to lead their party. Judith Collins has never been one of them. But she now has 65 days to convince you and the roughly 3.2 million other New Zealanders enrolled to vote that she and the party she leads are a government in waiting. It's a big job, but by golly, she wanted it. And as she said last night, surrounded by a caucus that 24 hours earlier could not have seen this happening, I can't wait to take the fight to this government. Judith Collins, congratulations and welcome to the program.
Oh, well, thank you, John. Great to be here.
Why you, do you think?
Well, I think it's just that I'm the right person for the job at this time, and that's what the caucus felt. And I think I'm just so thrilled at the support from that caucus. And you saw it last night after the announcement was made. I just think we've just got to do what we have to do, and I'm just thought, let's just do it. Let's just make this happen.
Okay, and what is this? What are you making happen?
Right, well, the team is a really good team, and what we want to do is we want to take back government, because we know that the country is going through difficult economic times now, and it's nothing to what's going to be coming around the corner once the wage subsidies come off. And we know that people, New Zealanders, are really concerned about what's happening to them and their jobs. So we believe that we are the right party to lead the next government, and we're the right people to help New Zealanders have a better work-life opportunities than the current government.
And what will you do differently from the current government?
Well, we are focusing very much on the economy. And I think one of the big issues that we've talked about in the past is about getting people into work, infrastructure, building for the future, but at the same time not overburdening the country with debt. We think that's really important, that we don't have so much debt that the next generation, the one after that, still paying for it.
So is infrastructure your response to the post-COVID-19 economy?
Well, infrastructure is very important, and obviously we've got some speeches coming on very soon on that and other issues. But I think it is really important that we focus on people in work, but also not on taxing the whole country so that we never actually get ahead as a people. So we believe very firmly that we can make things better.
You deserve this job, and by God, you had three chance cracks at it and you want it. But you're just making this up as you go along. I mean, have you arrived with a fully formed policy position? What's the difference between you and Todd Muller other than, as you described it last night, you're tough?
Well, the thing is, Todd Muller and I agree on a lot of our policies. That's the whole point. We've had our policy process all the way through. But right at the moment, we've got a whole suite of speeches that are due to come out very soon, which I'll be delivering.
Are they the same speeches Todd Muller would have made?
Well, they will be changed, obviously, because they will suit my style, which is not the same as Todd's. But it is very important, for instance, say with RMA reform, that is a major part of what we're talking about.
Yeah, RMA reform is a big thing for you. Mm. What is your style? And I want to go back to dirty politics and what we learned about you and that correspondence between you and Cameron Slater. And you said in emails to Cameron Slater, if you can't be loved, then best to be feared. Is that who you are, someone to be afraid of?
I think, John, that most people would know me very well, will know that I have a sense of humour. Sometimes that humour works, sometimes it doesn't. And people make all sorts of comments when they're talking to people in a private capacity that they don't expect someone's going to go and steal emails and then go and use them against them. So my style is very collaborative. You can ask around Parliament. There are people I've worked with for years.
Okay. Because, and this is the last time I'll quote from Dirty Politics, but
yeah,
I think, but what Nicky Hager said is, and I quote verbatim, what Collins and Cameron Slater shared most were dislikes and enmities. Their hostility towards many people in the National Party was at least as strong as their dislike for their political opponents. And as Richard Harman pointed out this morning, this is your third crack at it, and your first two times you got only a handful of votes. Actually, you haven't been liked by your own party on occasions, have you?
Well, most people who put their hands up for these positions actually lose the first time or so. And the thing is that if you read my book, a far better book than Dirty Politics, it's called Pull No Punches, and by the way, is a bestseller in New Zealand, unlike Dirty Politics. that shows you very clearly.
I think Clearly, Politics was a bestseller at the time.
No, but it's surpassed by my book, John, and much more positive book, and it's actually true. So I think it's really important that people say, well, why would you stop people putting their hand up for something just because they might lose? The fact is, you never get anything done. I know, for instance, with this job I've got now, it's a tough job, but we can do it.
Okay. I want to look at some of the things you've stood for and against. You voted for marriage equality and you voted for end-of-life choice, which actually puts you in a minority in the National Party, doesn't it?
Yes. I'm in a happy position of being both Conservative and Liberal.
What does that mean? Explain that to me.
Well, I used to say to people when they're worried about the Marriage Equality Act, I just say everyone deserves a mother-in-law. And mostly they'd get it. Basically, I just think leave government out of people's lives if you can possibly do it and let people make their own choices. It's part of being a free society.
So what sort of government would you run then? Particularly, because when you say leave government out of people's lives, it seemed to me that about two or three minutes ago you were saying cometh the hour, cometh the government. It's time for more government now, given how precarious everything is.
It's really more about an enabling government. One of the things that government should do is facilitate business to, for instance, do business and not get in the way constantly.
But what does that mean?
Well, it means actually looking at the rules and regulations and everything else that we do and say, what is it the government can do to help business to do their job?
Oh, yeah, OK. But you had 9 years to get the RMA, to get those rules and regulations right. What has Labor done that needs undoing? I mean, what did you not get right last time in government?
Well, we didn't have the numbers to do the RMA reform that we wanted, but also we didn't have a consensus across New Zealand that this needed to be very seriously changed. And we now have that. I mean, I've worked with the environmental groups as well as the business groups. We know that this needs to be changed. The time is now. And there's nothing like a crisis, which we have at the moment, in terms of the economy coming up, to actually get us all focused on what's important, which are the New Zealanders that we represent.
Can we just go quickly through your shadow cabinet? Nicky Kay, will she be education?
I think so, yeah. Okay. There's any reason not to.
Yeah. Michael Woodhouse, health?
We're just going to talk about that this morning because I've got a couple of changes to make. But I spoke to Nicky. I'm just saying Nicky because I spoke to her last night and she was very keen to keep it. And I haven't spoken to Michael yet.
What will you say to him when you speak to him? You can speak to him now. I'm sure he's watching.
I would like to know more about what happened last week, so I wasn't party to it. And I think I need to get my head very much around what happened and just to make some decisions on that.
Are you saying that it potentially was damaging and that if you think that his behaviour was not as it should be, you don't want to take him into the election as your health spokesperson?
I think it's important I know the facts, and I don't know the facts. I've only seen some comment in the media, and there's been quite a lot of comment, and I need to have those facts. And I think this is a very serious issue, what happened with the patient's information, the 18 people whose privacy was so seriously breached. I want to know everything else about what happened there before we come to any conclusions.
Dr. Shane Retty is a good standby too, isn't he? And an actual doctor.
Dr. Shane Retty is not just a doctor. I mean, he's a specialist. This guy's lectured at Harvard. He is a top-notch person and a great MP.
I looked at you and Judith Collins. God, that's a...
Judith Collins.
Judith Collins. You can take her. That's just being a Hurricane supporter. Dear old RIP, Judith Collins. I looked at you and Jerry Brownlee last night, and I thought to myself, you know, on the one hand, boy, you're competent, and boy, you're tough, and boy, you're experienced. But are you too experienced? 42 years in Parliament between you. You are, what, 18 years now, 2002? Judith Collins is 24 years, 1996.
Jerry Brownlee.
God damn it. Judith Collins, Jerry Brownlee. Jerry Brownlee is 24 years, so 42 years in total. Is this back to the future? I mean, are you the modern, new 21st century face of the National Party, you and Jerry Brownlee?
Well, I think that this is such a difficult time that we're about to go into in our economy and for our country, that the one thing we really need is competency, and we also need experience, and that's what we've got.
Judith Collins, thank you so much for joining us this morning, and congratulations on being leader of the National Party.
Thank you.
We look forward to talking to you lots between now and the election.